How's it going, bros? This is AJ on this side with a new video in which I'll tell you how to control the speed of your system fans. So stay tuned. One thing to note here in this video is that I'll only talk about controlling the fan speed, but I would not recommend you to change your system's fan speed unless you properly know about your system. Things like if your fans are connected to the 3-pin or 4-pin sockets in the motherboard, or are they connected to the PSU directly through the Molex plug, etc., that kind of stuff. The point is, you better be sure what you are doing with the system, otherwise you may get stuck in a system failure or something like that. But don't worry, because the software that I am going to use today in this video will be able to give you some information about the fans so that you don't have to pop your case open to check that. Another thing that I figured out in the middle of my little research is that this software does not support some systems, and unfortunately mine is one of them too. But because I was like 90% done with this video project, I decided to at least guide you guys so you can go check whether this method works for you or not. You just follow what is being told in the video, and if the software is able to change your fan speed, then well and fine. Otherwise you can go with the methods that I described at the end of this video. Okay, here we are with the main tutorial. First, go ahead and download the software called SpeedFan from the link in the description. As you are seeing in this video, I'll assume that you'll be able to install and run the program on yourself. I've already installed it, and I have used it for monitoring the temperature of my components, and I gotta say, it does that job pretty well. Also, we don't need to see the program to see the temperature of the system or the motherboard, because it shows it right here, right now. As you can see, it shows 38 degrees, 37 degrees, and I guess it doesn't matter a lot, but it's a nice little tweak. Okay, so here is the program itself. As you can see that there are various tabs present here, out of which we'll only go through the readings tab. I will totally not recommend you to do any kind of changes in this clock tab, because it's totally related to overclocking and stuff, which is to be performed only when you have enough knowledge about things like this. Other than the readings tab, we don't have many things relative to this video, but yeah, the charts tab can be used to see graphical data of temperatures, voltages and fan speeds of the components, etc. Moving on with the tutorial, as you can see right here, we have various fans listed, like system fan, CPU fan and some other fans. The one which shows any kind of RPM value other than zero, it means that that particular fan is connected to your motherboard. In my case, all my case fans are connected to a fan hub which is directly powered by my PSU. Thus, the RPM in these fields shows zero. But my CPU fan is connected to the motherboard, so there is some RPM value being shown, that is like 767 RPM or something like that. As you can see, it's constantly changing. Now, as you can see on the right side, that we have the temperature of the main components of the computer. If you see that your CPU is cool enough and still the fan is moving with a high RPM making a lot of noise, then you can go ahead and decrease the percentage of this fan speed from here, like this. While doing this, I recommend doing little changes first and seeing how the CPU or any other component that you chose is holding up, and then gradually adjust the fan speed. Just try not to go boom with the fans, okay? That's all I can tell you about fan speed right now. I'm very sorry that I'm not able to show you guys the RPM changing, but what can I do? The software isn't compatible with my hardware. I'm so sorry. Sorry about that, bros. And if in case this doesn't work for you too, then you can go ahead in your BIOS to change your fan speed, or you can get an external fan controller. I guess I'll upload a tutorial in the future showing how to do these things, but not sometime sooner, I guess. The best way to learn how to change your fan speed in BIOS is to open your motherboard's manual, because these types of things have some basic steps, or should I say concepts, but for very specific step-to-step guide, you should try to understand it from your manual or something, because it's difficult to find out good tutorials that use your motherboard as an example to tell how to change fan speed, etc. Okay, this tutorial has been going way too long, so I'm gonna stop now, because otherwise to explain all the concepts it will take a lot more than one short video. So hope this tutorial was helpful for you. If it was, give it a like and an awesome comment. Also subscribe, because there's a lot of stuff coming on a regular basis. I'm working hard in to put all this together. I would really appreciate some positive response to keep me going. Okay, thanks for watching, and I'll see you bros in the next one. Peace.